हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ वेलकिन नेशनल स्कूल। दिस इज मिसेस दीपा वल्लाकाटी, द सब्जेक्ट टीचर ऑफ मैथ्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न चैप्टर नंबर 14, कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 8। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस ईयर वी हैव लर्न रिगार्डिंग द सिंपल इंटरेस्ट। येस नो, वॉट इज सिंपल इंटरेस्ट? दैट वेन एवर वी आर कीपिंग आवर मनी और वेन एवर वी टेक इन मनी, दैट मीन्स वी लेंड द मनी और वी टेक इन द मनी, at that moment we need to pay the interest. How we gonna calculate that interest? That we call it as a simple interest. We will gonna calculate that interest like the principal amount multiplied by the rate of interest multiplied by the number of years divided by 100. Yes, no? And we will gonna find out the amount, that the total amount what we have taken or given plus the interest. This we call as an amount. Yes, no? But in compound interest, how we will going to calculate this compound interest? That we will calculate the compound interest on this, if we have taken the 1,000 rupees, okay, if we have taken 1,000 rupees from the bank, okay, and we have paying 10% of interest on it, okay. So at the end of the year, how we will, what we will get? We will get 1,100, correct? No, this is our amount, that is principal amount is 1,000, on 10% of it will come to 100 rupees, that the amount has come to 110 rupees. For the next year we will calculate compound interest on this, okay. So compound interest mein ye hota hai, simple interest mein hum log always principal amount pe कैलकुलेट करते हैं, लेकिन कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट में हम लोग ऑलवेज इंटरेस्ट एक्रूड होता रहता है, मतलब इंटरेस्ट ऑलवेज ऐड होता रहता है, ओके. सो व्हाट इज़ द फॉर्मूला फॉर फाइंडिंग दिस कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट? दैट कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट इक्वल्स टू प्रिंसिपल मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 1 प्लस आर अपॉन 100 रेश टू एन. नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दिस. व्हाट इज दिस? इज कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. This is our principal amount 1. R is rate of interest here divided by 100. Here n means number of years, okay, and R means rate of interest, as we have calculated, as we known, like in the simple interest, okay. Let's start with the sums. See, in this question, find the compound interest on rupees 5000 for 2 years, okay. So here the principal amount is what? The principal amount is 5000 rupees and number of years are 2. For the 2 years it has taken, and the rate of interest is R. Rate of interest is 10% per annum is given. Yes, no? Now, we need to find out what? We need to find out the compound interest. Therefore, put on the formula that A equals to P 1 plus R upon 100 raised to n. Now just simply put on the amounts. P is 5000 and 1 plus R is what? 10 upon 100 raised to 2. Okay, now 100 ones are 100. If I take the LCM of both, 100 ones are 100, 100 ones are 100 plus 10 raised to 2. Here comes the 5000. So it will gonna be calculated like this way, that 5000, 100 plus 10 comes to 110 upon 100 raised square, okay. Now when I multiply this, that means when I make it the square, what I will get? 0 0 will get cancelled. So 11 square is 121 and 10 square is 100, correct? It should be multiplied by 5000. So when I cancel this, the zero will, two zeros will come cancelled. So the point, the digit will come from two digits here. So the point will come like 5000 multiplied by 1.21. When I multiply this, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 1 carries over here, 5 ones are 5. Plus 1, it comes to 6, okay, and the 000, the digit is coming after 2, so here it comes, the answer of my amount is 6050, okay. This is my amount. Now I need to find out the compound interest. So compound interest equals to what? Compound interest equals to amount minus principal. Here what I amount I have got 6050 minus my principal is 5000. So what is compound interest? How much compound interest I have got? 1050 rupees. Okay. See, the question is, Dattu has borrowed 12,800 from the bank for 3 years. At the rate of 12.5% per annum, at the compound interest, what amount must he pay to the bank at the end of the 3 years? Here we need to understand that Dattu has taken 12,800 from the bank for 3 years, okay, at the rate of 12.5%. So at the end of the 3 years, how much amount that Dattu has to pay to the bank? Now let's see. Here the principal amount is 12,800, correct? Next, rate of interest is 12.5. We will also write in this way, 12.5, okay, 12.5% per annum, and number of years are 3 years. Here we need to find out what amount he has to pay to the bank after 3 years. Now let us start. Put on our formula. A equals to P multiplied by 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Here our P is 12,800. Okay. And 1 plus 12.5 upon 100 raised to 3. Which comes to, this will come here, that 100 plus 12.5, it comes to 112.5 upon 100 raised to 3 or cube, 12,800 multiplication. Okay, now let's tell you how this will gonna be calculated here. See, 100 plus 12.5 upon 100, because 100 multiplied by 1, it comes to 100. Okay, and इसको हम लोग मिक्स्ड फ्रैक्शंस को किस तरीके से हम लोग एडिशन करते हैं एलसीएम निकालने के लिए वैसे ही किया है. ओके, नाउ व्हाट आई हैव गॉट हियर, आई हैव गॉट 12,800 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 112.5. ओके, व्हेन आई कैंसिल दिस टू, दिस डिजिट विल कम अप टू हियर. When I cancel these two zeros, the digit will come from here to here, the two digits. So it will be 1.125 the cube. When I multiply 1.125 and 1.125 and the answer with the 1.125, what I will get? I will get 1.4238 approximately. Okay, which I will multiply with our principal amount. So what I will get here when I multiply both of these things, I will get 18,224 rupees point 64 paise. It is coming up to 18,224.64 paise. So at the end of the 3 years, Dattu will pay 18,224.64 paise to the bank. Children, see, the population of the city increased at the compound rate of 8% per year. Okay, here they are saying that whatever in the city, the population will increase at the compound rate of 8% per year. That means har saal mein 8% ka un logon ka population increase hota hai. Find the population in the year of 2012. If the population in the year 2010 was 2,50,000. ओके, सो 2,50,000 क्या है हमारा पॉपुलेशन है 2010 में. सो दिस इज आवर, लेट अस टेक दिस इज आवर प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट, एंड द अमाउंट we need to find out for the year 2012. So here the rate of interest increasing 8% per annum, and the number of years are, what is the gap between the 2010 and 2012 are 2011 and 12. That means 2 years, no? So here I am taking the number of years are 2. Now let us try that A equals to P multiplied by 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Now 250,000 multiplied by 100 N, it comes like 1 plus 8 upon 100, no, raised to 2. So 100 1 multiplied by 1 is 100 plus 8 is 108 upon 100. So when I cancel these two zeros, the point will come in between. That means 1.08 raised to square, 1.08 square is there, no? So I'll multiply these two numbers twice. So what I will get, 1.08 multiplied by 1.08, 8 8s are 64, 8 zeros are 0, 6 comes here, 8 ones are 8, 0 0 0, then after, then afterward 108, what I am getting here, 4, 6, 8 plus 8, 16, 0, 1 and 1, okay. So here I am getting what, 1.1664. So whenever I'll multiply 1.1664 with the 250,000, I will get 291,600. So at the end of the year 2012, the population of that city will gonna be 291,600 population. Okay. Children, see in this question, there are 15,625 trees in the forest. Okay, in a forest there are total 15,625 trees are there. If the target of increasing the number of trees is decided to be 8% per annum, that means har saal 8% ke accordingly hai na ye फॉरेस्ट के अंदर ट्रीज को वो लोग डेवलप करना चाहते 8% इंप्रूवमेंट के साथ. हाउ मेनी ट्रीज विल बी देयर इन द फॉरेस्ट आफ्टर 3 इयर्स. सो दिस एम ऑल वी हैव टू डू इन द सेम वे. नाउ वी विल टेक द प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट एज 15,625 एंड द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज 8% एंड नंबर ऑफ इयर्स इज 3 इयर्स. नाउ put on the formula, A equals to P 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Here the P is 15,625 and 1 plus R, that is 8 upon 100 raised to N, is 3 years. Okay. Now let us take the LCM. It comes to 100, 108 upon and that cube, and the number P will come as it is 15,625. When I cancel this, 0, 0 will get cancelled and the point comes between the 1.08. So the answer is 15,625 is to be multiplied by the 1.08 multiplied by 1.08 multiplied by 1.08. In the last sum we did, the square of the 1.08, we have got 1.1664. Correct, no? And this here we have to multiply it by the thrice, that means cube. So when I multiply the same answer with this, I have got 1.259712, which means 1.259712. Here I have to multiply it with the 15,625. When I do the calculations between both of these, what I have got? I have got 19,683 number. Okay. So at the end of 3 years in the forest, at the end of the forest, we will get 19,683 number of trees are there in the forest. Okay. See, in this question, calculate the difference between the compound interest and the simple interest on rupees 10,000 at the rate of 5% per annum for 2 years. So here principal amount is 10,000. Okay, rate of interest is 5% per annum and number of years are 2 years. So here we need to find out both the things, that the simple interest also and the compound interest also, and we need to understand that where it is more profitable. Otherwise we can find out that what is the actual difference between the simple interest and the compound interest. We all know that simple interest we calculate on the principal amount, but compound interest we will calculate on first year. We will calculate it on the principal amount, but on the second year we will calculate the principal amount plus on the interest. Okay, so let us start with the simple interest, that I equals to P into R into N upon 100, or I into P into T upon 100, correct? No, so here this is 10,000, rate of interest is 5, number of years are 2 upon 100. 0, 0, 0, 0 will get cancelled. 5 to the 10, and 10 multiplied by 100 is 1000. So simple interest, what we have got? We have got simple interest at 1000 rupees. Okay. Now let us find out the compound interest. For that, we need to find out the amount. Now put on the formula P 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. So here this is 10,000. This is 1 plus 5 upon 100 raised to 2. So 1000 10,000 multiplied by 1 plus R upon 100, that is 5 upon 100. It comes to 100 plus 5 upon 100 the whole square. Here it comes the principal amount 10,000. Okay, so again it will be 10,000 upon multiplied by 105 upon 100 the whole square. So again it will be 10,000 multiplied by 00 will get cancelled. So the point comes over here, 1.05, the whole square means 1.05. Okay. So when I calculate this, I will get 1025. Okay. I will get 1.1025, that I should multiply with the 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I am multiplying, the number will go, the digit will go from here to the here, the 4 digit backs. So answer I will get 11025. Okay, this much rupees. So this is what, this is my amount 11025. And here I need to find the simple compound interest. So compound interest equals to A minus P. So here A is 10,000. 10,000 minus, sorry, here our A is 11025. 11025, and minus the principal amount is 10,000. So what extra amount I am getting? 1025 as a compound interest. Here I can see my simple interest is 1000 and compound interest is 1025. So the difference between simple interest and compound interest is 1105. 1025 minus simple interest is 1000. So what is the difference in both of these is the 25 rupees. Understood? Now try to understand this last question. Find the principal which amount is 23,152.50 paise at the rate of 5% per annum compounded annually for the 3 years. So in this sum we have understood that here we need to find out the principal amount. We need to find out the principal amount, but the compound interest has given 23,152.50 rupees. Okay, and the rate of interest is 5% per annum. Number of years are 3. Now let us start that A equals to P 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Here we know what? We know amount. Now let us put on the amount on its place. And P we doesn't know. Let it be P only. Okay. Don't make any changes in that. 1 plus R is what? 5 upon 100 raised to 3. When I do these calculations, what I will get? 105 upon 100 raised to 3, P as it is, and the amount is also as it is. Okay. Now, when I cancel these two, the amount will gonna be 1.05. So here P multiplied by 1.05 cube. No, so I will multiply this number by 3 times 1.05. So 1.05. Now let us do the calculations over here. Okay, 1.05 multiplied by 1.05, 5 5s are 25, 5 comes here, 2 remain over there, 5 0s are 0, 2 comes here, 5 1s are 5. Then afterward 0 is, if multiply any of the number by the 0, we will get 0 only. So I have put 0 0 0, and 1 5s are 5, 1 0s are 0, 1 1s are 1. Okay, so when I add them together, what have we got? I have got 11025, and the number comes after 4 digits, so the amount is 1.1025. because here we need to multiply it by the 3 times, so 2 times multiplication I have got 1.1025. that number I will multiply again by the 1.05. so what I will get? 5 5 is 25, 5 comes here, 2 remains over there, 5 2s are 10, plus 2 will come 12, 1 remain over here, 5 0s are 0, plus 1 will come 1, and 5 1s are 5, 5 1s are 5. Now any number will get multiplied with the 0, I will get 0 only, second term is 0. Now 1 5s are 5, 1 2s are 2, 1 0s are 0, 1 1s are 1, 1 1s are 1. When I added them all together, what I have got? 5 2 6 7 5 1 and 1. So 1 2 3 4 5 6. So I'll put my digit after 6 from left to right to the left. 1 2 3 4 5 6. I've kept it over here. Okay. So my amount is 1.1576.25. So instead of taking the 6 digit, I will follow up to the 1.1576. Why? Because ये 5 नंबर रहने से इसका नंबर एक इंक्रीज होएगा, लेकिन इसका नंबर इंक्रीज होने से यहाँ पे इंक्रीज नहीं होने वाला है. दैट यू ऑल नो, इफ एनी ऑफ द डिजिट इज शोइंग लाइक दिस वे और दिस वे, दैट मीन्स इफ 5 नंबर इज देयर, द नंबर बिफोर इट विल, द नंबर बिफोर इट विल इंक्रीज बाय 1 नंबर. बट हियर इंक्रीजिंग इट won't make changes in the number 6. That is why I have taken this up to 1.1576. Okay. So it comes to 1.1576 multiplied by P. This is 23152.50. Okay. Now see here. So what I will do, this is my numerator, this is also my numerator. If I'll bring it on the either side, it will become my denominator. So 23152.50 upon 1.1576, which equals to what? Which equals to P. Okay. Now I don't know this table. Now let's form this table. Okay. 1.1576 multiplied by 2. Okay, so what I will get? 2 6 are 12, 2 7s are 14 plus 1 15, 2 5s are 10. Okay, sorry, I need to make it simple thing. 1.1576, I need to add it up. 1.11576. 1.1576. 6 plus 6, 12. 7 plus 7, 14 plus 1, 5. Okay, this comes to 10. 3.2. Okay, see here in this, 6 plus 6, 12 comes 1 here. 7 plus 7, 14 plus 1, 5. And 1 come here, 5 plus 5, 10 plus 1, 1 come here. 1, 2, 3, 3 and 2 comes. So 2.3152. So here also I have got 2.152. 2.152. So what I will do? 1s are, 2s are. And how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 I am putting. So here my principal amount is total 20,000. Understood?